4.
An angry silence lay where love had been, and in your eyes a look I'd never seen. If I had found the words, you might have stayed. But as I turned to speak, the music played. As lovers danced their way.
Oh man, okay, that is my favorite singer. Male.
Matt Monroe.
My absolute favorite singer. And also my favorite female singer is Chelsea Conrad.
That would be your daughter.
Yeah, yeah. I hear her sing. I get emotionally moved. She's got a lot of soul. A
little bit of nepotism there, you think?
No, no. I've got seven daughters, and I don't say they can all sing. Okay. She can sing. Let's talk to Barbara.
Can Barbara sing?
I want to talk to Barbara. Hey, Barbara.
Hey, Barbara.
Hello,
hey,
guys.
Barbara. First, we got to say hello to Emma Rose Casey. There's Emma Rose Casey. Can you hold that up?
Sure, I'd hold it up for you, Bob.
Good. Okay. And that's a wonderful picture. And I want to thank her mother for sending the picture to us. Okay, no, that's just her note, okay? And she's one of our regular listeners. And there's your beautiful daughter. And let me see. Arrived Thursday, March 25th, and 8 pounds, wow. And it's a girly. Okay, go ahead, Barbara, I'm sorry. What's up, babe?
Nope, that's fine. You look very good in that shirt today.
Oh, wow, thanks. You know, instead of wearing my sloppy stuff, I'm wearing these little shirts I find in the closet. Now that I moved, the only guy in the house is me, and I'm discovering my wardrobe. But thank you for that. What's up?
A couple of weeks ago, I was talking to you, Mario and the mob, and you told us that one of those little boys was your grandson.
Yeah, Jesse.
Yeah, I was wondering if any of the other kids were your grandsons.
In that little group, the beautiful blonde girl, that was my daughter. She doesn't act anymore. She is really into school. And Tristan, her son, my daughter's name is Tammy, her son is an honor student, straight A's. Now he's in high school. He's getting A's and B's. But she gave up acting, and Jesse's still at it. He is 27 years old now, and his wife is 3 months pregnant. And I'm very excited about that. He's a wonderful boy, and he is the son of my firstborn child, and her name is Joan, Marjorie Joan. I named her after her mother, and she blessed my life by coming into it when I was 17. Yeah, go ahead, Barbara.
Did you use any of your other grandkids or anything in any of the other movies your company made?
No, only grandchild was Jesse, and I used all my children and my dog in all my films. And that's one of the things, there was a time in my career, after I had done Centennial, I got the best reviews of my career, and I could have made a transition and done just feature motion pictures, or I could have run my own company and made movies for television. I made movies for television, never regretted it, because my daughter ran the company. Paula Dupree, who was one of our employees, got the Academy Award this year. And so anyway, that's the choice I made. And I had a lot of my kids, a lot of my nephews, but no more, and a lot of my friends, and no more grandkids, okay?
All right.
Thanks, Barbara. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I appreciate that.
Hey, Bob, did I hear you say your dog was in your movies?
Yeah, my dog. We needed a dog.
Did he used to get paid? Did you pay him?
No, I would have, though.
Hey, wait a minute. You made the pet work for no money?
Absolutely, because it ate a lot of food.
I see. Okay. Are you getting an email or you want to go to Joe in Tennessee?
No, I want to do an email, then I want to talk to Joe.
But, okay.
Flying down to Burbank to see me is quite a trip from Seattle. So I don't know if you want to do that, Mike. A few minutes of time. Call me if you want to talk to me on the radio show, and we can talk. And then we can talk about whether or not it's a good idea for you to come all the way down here to get an autograph and or to meet me. So you can reach us here at, our number at the...
That would be 800-336-2225.
Oh, yeah, that's the call-in number. So I don't know what to do with this. I don't want you to come all the way here, but I wanted to acknowledge it. Let's not discard that one, okay?
I'll put it in a special file.
All right, now, next is Joe from Tennessee. Hey, Joe, what's up, my man?
Hi, Duke and Jack.
Hey, Joe, how are you doing?
I love that accent of yours, man. I love that accent of yours.
Oh, thanks.
Yeah, I really do. Yeah, no, I hung around, you know, with a whole group of guys from Tennessee. I just called one a couple days ago, and they were my dear, dear, dear friends.
Was one of those guys Red West?
Yeah, and one's and Elvis Presley.
Sure. Yeah, well, and
Elvis was
Red's,
a buddy, and that
Red's
whole
doing a lot of movies now.
Oh yeah, I just finished one with Kevin Fowler Spacey.
That's right, your buddy.
Right, so Joe, yeah, but we think we better get him on the show, or I'm gonna have to go and, you know,
okay,
handle him. All right, so what's up, Joe?
Well, I got a question for you tonight about Wild Wild West.
Go ahead.
What brand hat did you wear?
It wasn't a brand. We had a woman designer, and she designed that whole outfit, the pants, the jacket. And if the pants were too tight, that was her fault.
What was her name?
I don't remember right now. It's been quite a few days ago. But she was with a top, a Western costume. That's where we got the wardrobe.
And the pants were very tight.
They were very tight. But anyway, I don't remember her name, but she was the art, that was the clothes designer. Anything else, Joe, before we let you go?
That's all I've got. A bunch of people want to know.
Well, good. That's, they weren't, we made the hat. That was ours.
Even better.
Thank you, man.
See you, Joe.
Okay, see you.
You know, I'm going through Manhattan, which I moved to this, oh, gosh, gorgeous house. It's lease. I don't own it. I owned the last one. But I wanted to take this opportunity to thank our listeners for this house. I mean, without you people that are calling in and listening to the show and have watched my acting, I wouldn't be able to be in this luxurious, beautiful, beautiful house. It's very, very comforting for me because I live there alone, and it's very rewarding.
Do you get lonely?
I get lonely. I have a beautiful view. I have a beautiful view, and I don't have a puppy or a dog right now, and I'm going to work some out with the girls where they come. Each one comes one day a week and stays with their dad. But that's a whole nother story. So here we have from Denise, and she wants to know, here's what she said, and this is wonderful. She knows how difficult it is with spinal cord injury. She was diagnosed when she was 40 with the spinal muscular, and things in your life change a lot, but you make the changes go away. I was a kindergarten teacher. Instead of giving up teaching, which the doctor suggested, I reinvented myself going back to school for reading special needs. I love what I do. God closed the door, but he opens windows. It appears you found one of the windows too. Thanks for being an inspiration. Hey, Denise, God bless you, kid. I am spinal cord damaged, and I know what you're talking about. So I thank you for your strength, and thank you for your prayers. And we're going to Nevada next. And again, hey, I was really moved by what you had to say in that letter. Thank you for that.
The PM Show with Robert Conrad. I'm Jack Robertson from Mike Horn. We're live across the nation, this radio station, this cable system. Hi to everybody at WBIX in Boston. And the email here, rconrad@crni.net. rconrad@crni.net. Straight ahead, Nevada, and more emails.
Yeah, boy, I want those emails, and we're going to talk to Mike, and I am anxious to do that. It'll come to me. I'm having short-term memory.
It'll come to you.
Well, I was jammed, man, when I was in that accident, and when I got to it, it was horrendous.
You're pumped. The engineer is waving me. We'll get to it. We'll get to it, Paul. We'll be right back.
Lee Klein again for OC Nissan Irvine. Whether you have solid gold credit or your credit just plain